Hey, what's up guys? I'm Theo Joe, and today I've got a bunch of really cool Chrome extensions that I'm pretty sure you've never heard of, because this list is made up of extensions that all have less than 1,000 ratings on the Chrome Web Store, so it's not like these are gonna be the cliche ones that you always hear about. And at the end, if you're interested, I'll put a link to another video with even more extensions that I made before. But anyway, let's get started. First up, this one I know is really gonna come in handy. It's called Print Eliminator. And this is for all the times where you went to print a web page, but it ends up looking terrible because there are so many things on the site that clutter it up or mess up the formatting. With this, it lets you simply click on different assets on the site and removes them, so they won't be there when you go to print. This is also useful if you want to take a screenshot of a website and you want to remove annoying stuff like the social media icon links, or you want to remove sensitive information before printing or screenshotting as well. So there's lots of different uses here. Next up, number two, is called Rescroller, which lets you customize the scroll bar for Chrome. And this could be good for both visual and practical reasons as well that I can talk about. And it works pretty simply. You just go into the extension and then choose different options for how it looks, like the width, the color, the fill of the scroll bar, and if it should even have rounded corners, and even if you want to change what color it is when you hover over it. But besides that, I think this extension could be helpful to anyone who has a really high resolution monitor. For example, maybe you have a 4K monitor, so the scroll bar seems smaller compared to the rest of the screen. With this extension, you can just adjust the scroll bar size so it's bigger and easier to click on with bigger screens. Or maybe just the opposite, where you're on a small screen and you want the scroll bar to be smaller, who knows? I'm sure you can think of a lot of different ways to use it. All right, number three is also a cool one. It's called Font Face Ninja, and it simply tells you what different fonts are being used on any website. But not only that, it will give you links to where you can actually download the font to use yourself, and whether it's a free font or one you might have to buy. How it works is you click on the icon for the extension to activate it, and the first thing you'll see is an entire list of the fonts on the site. But the cooler thing is you can actually hover over any text on the site and it will show a little pop-up saying what the font that specific text is using. And plus, it will tell you everything from the current font size to the vertical and horizontal spacing and even the font color. So here's another neat thing. If you click on the font in the list, it will open up a text box so you can try out the font and resize it to see how it looks when you type stuff in it. And then there's also a link to a site where you can buy that font if you want, like I mentioned before. One thing to know though is sometimes it does really take long for it to respond. It'll be like you click it, nothing happens. You just kind of have to wait a little while. But in any case, if you've ever wondered how a certain site got their text to look some way, now you'll know. Number four, this one's actually a pretty well-known service, but I don't think many people realize there's an extension for it, and that is Wolfram Alpha. If you're not familiar, Wolfram Alpha is a site that's basically the ultimate calculator. Not only can it do pretty much any mathematical calculation ever, but you can also ask it information about almost anything. This includes information about chemistry, music, physics, geography, sports, computer science, history, yeah, pretty much anything. So for example, you can type in apple nutrition and it will give you everything you've ever wanted to know about apples. Or you could do something like Sun's Path, New York, and it will literally tell you where the sun will be at certain times. Or something simple like how long until New Year's. Again, there are just so many things it's capable of that there's no way I could even begin to go through them all. So you can just use the extension to search for anything that comes to mind, and it'll probably tell you more. Okay, number five is dead simple, but so useful. It's called New Tab Draft, and it just turns any new tab you open into a blank notepad, basically. And this is great for any time you want to write something down real quick and you don't want to have to open up Notepad, the program, or Microsoft Word or whatever. And you just click a new tab and there it is, a big blank space where you can type. And on the left hand side you can see that you can create a new blank note, so you can separate them out if you want to. And it does appear to save all your notes, it's not like it deletes them when you close Chrome. But if you do want to save them as a file, you can click the gear and hit Save Draft, or just hit Control S and it will save your note as a text file instantly. And here's a really cool thing that it can do also. If you type in a mathematical equation, such as 5 plus 5, then hit enter, it will give you the answer. And this is really awesome if you wanna do a few quick calculations and you wanna be able to keep track of them all. So yeah, it's really simple, really awesome. Moving on, number 6 is an extension made by Google themselves called Password Alert. And it's actually a security extension meant to let you know if you're getting phished, meaning you typed your password in somewhere you shouldn't have. How it works is if you're on any website and you type in your Google password on any site besides Google, it will warn you what you just did. So if you type in your password into a site that might look like Google, it will tell you, "Good job, dummy, you just had your password stolen because that wasn't a Google site." So it doesn't stop you from getting phished because it's not tracking every website you're going to. It just tells you after the fact, but at least in that case, you know to change your password immediately. Now, one thing to keep in mind is if you use your Google password for other sites, which you should not be doing, it will warn you if you log into those sites because you just typed in your Google password. It just happens to be the password for that other site as well. But again, just don't reuse passwords. You should know that by now. Okay, number 7 is also password related, but it's a bit more useful day to day. And this one is called Show Password. And like the name suggests, if you type in a password so it's blocked out with asterisks, you can actually hover over it to reveal it. And you might be wondering, why the heck would you want to do that? And I'll ask you this, how many times have you typed in a password, especially if it's a long one, and you feel like you just hit a wrong key while typing it? So what do you have to do? Of course, you have to go and delete the whole thing and type it again and hope you didn't type it wrong the second time. Instead, with this, if you think you hit a wrong key, you can just hover over the blanked out password and look, and then maybe only need to hit backspace once and fix one letter instead of having to type out the whole thing again. So yeah, it might not seem like this will save a bunch of time, but if you do it pretty often, I think you'll be glad you had it. All right, next up, this one is pretty fun mostly, but it might also be useful for anyone who's a developer. And it's called What Runs, and it can tell you all sorts of information about what software and frameworks were used to build any website. So for example, let's go on some tech website like Ars Technica, and we can see that, it looks like they use Ruby on Rails for the web framework. And plus it shows you some stuff like what programming languages were used, what kind of web server, what they use for analytics, and looks like even WordPress among others. And let's take a look at YouTube even. It tells you what kind of advertising they're using, which is AdSense obviously, and they're also using the Polymer JavaScript framework. Interestingly, YouTube actually looks pretty simple. They don't have a ton of different frameworks and add-ons and widgets, probably because everything's custom built, I assume. And this one is also good if you're just curious about building websites or already do it. All right, got a couple more. Number 9 is clipboard history. This one is pretty straightforward. It just keeps track of things you've had on your clipboard in the past. So whenever you copy something new, you can access what was there before by clicking the extension icon, where it gives you a pretty comprehensive list. So it'll show you what was there before, when you added it to the clipboard, and if you want to switch between things, you just click on them. Then on the right next to each one, there are options to favorite them, view the entire text if it was really long, and even store them on the cloud, which uses Chrome's cloud API, so it's stored on Google servers and only accessible to the Google account logged into Chrome. It's not like the extension has a service storing this. Of course, if you want, you can disable it from tracking the clipboard at times by disabling monitoring. And if you want, you can hit the trash can to clear all history, but it won't clear what's currently on the clipboard, probably because that's controlled by Windows. Still pretty cool. All right, finally, we have an extension called Visual Ping, which is also related to a website, and it's a service that basically lets you monitor websites for changes or a section of a website, and then will notify you if it does. With the extension, you can either choose to have the website server do the monitoring, in which case the free version lets you check once or twice a day, and you can also let your browser do it and check as often as you want. Of course, the difference is if you use your own browser, you have to keep it running and you'd have to be sitting in front of the computer to see what the notification says right away. Whereas if you use the cloud, it will check whenever and email you notification when it happens. You can probably imagine some good uses for this, like maybe there's some product that's out of stock that you want to buy. You could use this to keep track if it comes back in stock. Or if you're just waiting for some website to update with new information of any kind, in cases like that as well. I think you get the point. So yeah, that's it. 10 cool Chrome extensions I doubt you've heard of, except for maybe a couple, who knows. And if you think of any other cool ones, you can let us know down in the comments. If you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here, including another one with more Chrome extensions. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. And also consider enabling notifications by clicking the bell, or YouTube might not show you any new videos. Again, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys, so thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.